Our next step is to take the nodes that we've loaded and adjust them in some way and then save them back to the database. So go ahead and jump back to your module folder, and we're going to open up step 3 in the steps folder, and it's called modifying nodes, and it's for the stuff.module file. Go ahead and copy the entire code and then paste it over the code that's currently in your stuff.module file and save it. The only adjustments that we've made to this file are right here in this third example. We're doing a process similar to what we did before. We're clearing out the build array by just setting it to a blank array so that we can rebuild it and display the content from this example. And then we're loading multiple nodes, like we did in our previous example, by passing it some specific node IDs. And again, if your node IDs are different than this, feel free to adjust the script. And then what we're going to do is loop through each node and adjust the content of it. And we do so by accessing its properties. So we're going to, in this example, change the title to display the current time. So we're setting the node title, and we're accessing it like we would an object using this arrow. And we're setting it to node number, and then the node ID. Their title was changed at, and then we're passing it the date with a bit of formatting. Now that our node has changed in some way, we then need to save it. So we're going to use a function called node save, and we're just going to pass it the node object. It's that easy. The reason we want to use NodeSave instead of using a custom query and accessing the database directly is twofold. First is that it's just easier using NodeSave, especially if we stack it on top of NodeLoad and build our node object beforehand. And secondly, what NodeSave will do is it will trigger any hooks that are defined by other modules to act on the NodeSave action, and it will allow them to adjust their functionality based on our change here. Next, we're simply reloading the nodes, and just like in our previous example, we're just building them as a render array by passing them to node view multiple. And then we're giving it the teaser option here. Okay, so what we should see when we save this and display the script is that the titles of our three nodes will have changed, and they'll display, just like in our previous example, in a teaser mode. Okay, let's make sure our module is saved, and let's jump back to the browser and refresh the stuff page. Okay, now you see here, our titles are different. It says node number 50's title was changed at 9:30. And this happens to all three of our nodes that we were loading.